More and more people are realizing just how important it is to create great video, whether it's for your own personal brand or for your business. But finding an all-in-one solution that makes it easy to record, edit, and share that content can be a challenge. And that's where Riverside comes in, and I wanna tell you why I think this is a fantastic all-in-one platform, regardless of what skill set you're at, to be able to help you create and publish more content than ever before. Whether you are brand new to video editing and looking for the easiest tool to make content for yourself, or even if you're like me, who actually has a lot of experience with video production, Riverside still has tools that make it great no matter what level you're at, and that's specifically what I want to highlight in the editor. So right here, here's a main studio. You can see there is a video that I just posted on my YouTube channel, and I can go in here and just hit edit, and immediately I'm up and running. Now, what's really cool about this is you can edit a bunch of different ways, but my favorite way to edit, specifically in talking head style stuff similar to what I'm doing here or what I did in this video, is that as you see on the left-hand side here, everything is done in a transcript. So instead of having to go through and have tedious little cuts here and there to figure out what you liked and what you didn't, you can literally just look on the side here at your transcript and instantly take apart, highlight it, and delete it directly in the transcript. And it just does the cut for you in the actual video, right? So let's say, for example, that I wanted to take this little clip.
Most of the time when you think about a hybrid, the number one reason people choose a hybrid is because you get a little bit of both, electric and gas, which in turn gets you a lot of miles per gallon range.
So maybe I said, okay, I don't need to actually say that in the video. I can literally just highlight this section that I just did. I can hit delete and boom. Now it just removed it. Check this out.
Now what's interesting about the Ford F-150 is the hybrid version of the F.
Seamless edit, no work whatsoever. But maybe I said, oh, you know what? Actually, I do want to have that in there. I wanted to delete something else. I can literally just click that part that you see is now deleted. I hit restore, bring it back. Transcript-based editing is really, really cool because when you're doing long videos that are talking head style, whether it be a podcast or a live stream playback, whatever it is, or a video like this where for the most part, I'm really just talking through most of the stuff. Instead of having to go through and try to find certain things and find little areas, you can literally just look at the transcript and edit it naturally like you're editing a piece of text, and then it just does the cuts for you directly. You can also even click the search button here and talk about, hey, when did I talk about that pro power? And I can click Pro Power and you see, bam, it takes me right to that section. I also love that it does all these little scene markers that you can see down here and little chapter markers where you can see how it's basically just breaking down the sections of the video that I talked about. And it's doing that all automatically with AI, which is awesome. So you can see right here, it had a little section called Hybrid versus EcoBoost, understanding the mileage. And let's say I actually really wanted to take this specific section of the video, which is obviously all about that, and I wanted to make its own piece of content around that, I can literally just take any of these clips, for example, and I could maybe perhaps this part where I'm starting a new section saying about fuel efficiency. I could take this whole section and go right to the end of it where I'm talking about kind of where we're at. Let's just say it's this section. And I could literally just click on these three little dots and hit create new edit. And it will take that specific section, create a new edit with just that specific section. It's now a 1 minute and 22 second clip with one click of the mouse.
So one of the most common questions people ask is what kind of miles per gallon can you actually expect?
And then you see at the end of it here,
more gas. Before I upgraded my tire.
Okay, I obviously chose a random section, but you can see if I just said you're not using gas on the highway and I wanted to just basically take this part out and delete it, bam, now it ends right at that specific section. That's its own 1 minute and 22 second clip, exactly what I want it to be. I can hit export and just share that clip out. And I could also take it a step further though, because if I actually wanted to do more stuff to it, for example, if I wanted to add different music to it, you have tons of music in here that you can choose from that adds a lot. So if I took that 1 minute and 22 second clip, for example, that I just made here, and I wanted to put some music behind it,
So one of the most common questions people ask is, what kind of miles per gallon can you actually expect on a hybrid vehicle? Now, like I mentioned, it's not necessarily the same level of hybrid as you would from something like a Prius. You're not going to get 50 miles a gallon.
So I can just test different pieces here.
You're not really going to get many more miles per gallon than the EcoBoost. But it doesn't mean that it's not a pretty darn good miles per gallon for a full-size truck. Now, most gas engines get a...
Now, if I said, oh, maybe I like that one specifically, I could just really just go to this section right here, hit plus. You'll see that right where my playhead is, it basically throws that music. But if I said I'd want to start here instead, you could see that then when I start talking, just nice and easy. Just move things around just like you want.
Ask is what kind of miles per...
You can see that I can click on that dot there. I can replace that music and do different whatever else I want to it. I can obviously, just like any editor, I can extend or make that clip shorter. I can do whatever I want with it. I can get it to be that exact length if I want. Then maybe if I said, okay, well, I really like that clip, but actually I want to throw some captioning on it, because on social media these days, it's very important to caption things, right? So I could just choose any captioning that I like, maybe for this piece of social media. Maybe I like this one where it's kind of highlighting word for word what I'm talking about. I just click one button and you can see that instantly now it's perfectly captioned. And if I said, well, okay, well, I don't want to make it that color. I want it to match a little bit more of what I have the style of this video as. Maybe I want to make that highlight white and I want to make the text white. And now, because it already did all the transcript for me, just like this.
One of the most common questions people ask is, what kind of miles per gallon can you actually expect on a hybrid vehicle? Now, like I mentioned, it's not necessarily the same level of hybrid as you would from something.
See, the transcripts are incredibly accurate. I don't even see any specific mistakes at all in here. But the great thing is that even if it was wrong, all I have to do is just highlight any word, hit correct, and write whatever it is. But then we can take it a step further, because let's face it, the reality is the toughest part about social media these days is everyone has their own aspect ratio. Some things want vertical, some want 16:9, and it just kind of is annoying to change these things all the time and format the text back to what it was, and it's just a little bit annoying when you're not using Riverside. So I can literally just take this clip and say, you know what, I actually want this to be more for a short or a reel. So I want it to be 9:16. You can see that before I even choose it, it'll instantly show me a preview of what that's gonna look like. You can see here's a square one, or maybe just an audio only. But let's say I want it to be a reel and 16:9. And just like that, everything is instantly formatted. And let's say, oh, well, maybe I don't want the text to be right in the dead center of the video, because I don't want that to be kind of annoying. I can just move that text box and it will format everything, and now it's just going to be down there.
Good miles per gallon for a full size.
And you could also see what it's doing is it's using AI to also predict what part of the clip it needs to be centered on. So you can see that I'm perfectly centered and the AI is keeping these shots perfectly centered just based on its own knowledge.
Trip miles, as well as how many miles you've gone on the trip. And the more you are driving in the city and
maybe I said, okay, well, on this video, actually, you know what, I'd rather have the captions a little bit different than that, so I can just change the captions, and maybe I want to do just more standard ones like this. Maybe I want to do one line instead, or three lines instead, or maybe even I want to go crazy and do per word, no problem.
Something like a Prius, you're not going to get 50 miles a gallon or 60.
Obviously, that'd be a little annoying to read like that, but my point is, this is how easy it is to do this. To do this kind of text editing and to have captions and to do all this stuff is actually very time consuming when you're using your standard programs. And this makes it so simple to just instantly take this piece of content, put some captions on it. Maybe I want these captions, and maybe I want to change the color and I want to change the style. It's so simple. I could do this and I could change the font color and I could instantly just make it more in the center instead. You see perfect alignment guides and make it super simple.
Meaning that it's not a pretty darn good miles per gallon for a full size truck.
Okay, and then maybe let's just say I actually wanted to brand this a little bit, because, you know, you might want to put logos on it. It's as simple as just putting a logo in there, throwing the logo where you want. You can change the background. You can also, if you decided to, maybe you wanted to put another whole different title up here that said something else, Ford Truck Review. Just like in an editor, you still have options to do stuff. So what I love is that it has so many tools to make it really easy to edit video, but yet it's not like some of the easy to use ones that it's kind of like, here, we can do captions for you, but you can't really customize anything. I like the fact that it makes all this stuff very easy to do, but it doesn't force you to basically use it and not modify it at all. Let's say I just wanted to add a picture and I wanted it to be a roadway, whatever. I could just choose a random picture, and just like an editor, it puts it right in there, and I can move that picture around. You get the picture. Even if I don't want to use Riverside as my actual editor, it also is amazing at micro content, which is really important these days. So if I wanted to just take this clip and create magic clips from it, I can hit one button and you see that now all these little magic clips have just been created by itself. It's just predicting these different sections of the clip. And you can see how spot on they actually are. That if I go to this clip, for example, this is one that it just randomly chose by itself. And you can see here, it chose a perfect spot.
What's amazing about the F-150 Power Boost is that it has a fully functioning 9.2. I can do it from my truck is pretty outstanding.
And it chose this random clip perfectly about this generator mode that I'm talking about with this truck, right about to the spot about it. It's pretty outstanding. And it just is done. Like, that was one click of the button and it created a new piece of content. And once again, if I just want to change that captioning style to make it look different instead, no problem. If I wanted to add something additional, no problem. And I can literally just hit export. So you could take a 15, 20 minute video, for example, and create 5 or 6 pieces of micro content, put royalty free music on them very quickly with captioning in different formats, and be able to just get all this content for your various social medias with the click of a button. In order to make all these different 16:9 clips with different music and captioning in something like Final Cut, for example, would take hours to edit those little clips, create new timelines, to be able to put all the captioning on it, put different music on it, export it. This makes it so simple. Now, what's awesome though is it doesn't even stop there, because if I just decided to go to AI Producer here, you can see that I can actually set the pace and remove pauses and remove ums and ahs if that's a problem. This video has already been tweaked for that, so I don't really have to do that. You can see that I could even apply some magic audio to the track and it will just take that audio with the use of AI and just enhance the audio so it sounds even better. It just makes it so easy. You can filter out words with smooth speech, ums, ahs, certain words that you could just make sure that are never said. So I hope you can kind of see that what I think is really, really cool about Riverside is that regardless of what type of content creator you are, if you want the program to be your sole editor and only use that, it has the power to do it because you still have all the features you'd want in a standard editor. But also, even if you're someone that already has your editing workflow down from a standpoint of your top to bottom edit, but you're looking to have maybe someone help you create more micro content clips that you can post on social media, or maybe you want to do those yourself, Riverside does this unbelievably because of all those little tools built in. And being able to take one long form video, create 5 or 6 micro pieces of content in various formats, with captioning and titles, being able to create 20, 30 clips in different formats in a matter of literally minutes is really, really valuable for someone. And I've been using this a lot, even with our own client work, being able to take long form stuff and make it into short form content. It's been really, really fast and really valuable for that. So here's what I recommend for you. Try Riverside. I think you'd really be shocked of how much it can actually simplify your workflow. If you use the link down below, you get a free trial, so there's no obligation to sign up at all. And then if you decide to sign up, use my promo code Scott McKenna for 15% off your subscription. It really is a very, very powerful editor. It's especially powerful if you're someone that does podcasts or interviews, remote interviews. It is unbelievable at that. I didn't touch on that in this video. I did it on a previous video, but Riverside has been crushing that game forever. Being able to create great podcasts and then also do all those editing things after the fact. It's also phenomenal with live streaming. It really is an all-in-one software, and they are continuing to get better and better at the tools that are being built into that. They are really good at listening to their customers, giving feedback, and just making your life easier. I can't stand video editing personally, so anything that makes my life easier and faster like this is really, really a tool that I'm a big fan of. So use the link down below, try Riverside for yourself. I really think that you'd be impressed by it, and let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. Talk to you guys soon.